And let's get started without the video with this video. So in this video I'm going to be explaining you how to make this beautiful life chart which updates every 2 seconds or 1 second. I'm going to be teaching you how to do that. By the way, just a one thing, if you know how to add one more chart, because I had issues, I just wanted to replicate this chart below that, like I wanted to have multiple charts, but I was not able to do that. If you are able to do that, please let me know, and please share me the code, share the code as well. So let's get started with this tutorial, how to get a nice, amazing charts, like live charts in Flask Python, Python as backend, right? So let's get started without wasting much of time. I'm just gonna stop that right there. I'm gonna start from the scratch, or I can explain you this code right here, or let me just explain you the code. That's I think a better way to do that. So let's begin from the scratch. I have a main route. Basically it basically loads the HTML page, right? I have a route called as data, right, which has a method known as get and post. The first item is basically a time object, right? It's a time. Then the second object is just a random data, which is basically sensor value, can be temperature, humidity or stuff. So basically I just convert that into json.dump. I convert that into a JSON data, and I'm just returning that response. So the route data just has to do is basically it has to just give the set of data, right? So if I try to run it, and I can prove it to you what I mean by that. So if I just say like 127 this, hopefully it should load the Flask app, right? Here you can see the data is been loading, right? Now if I try to go to /data, I should get the data, hopefully. So here you can see these are the data, right? This is the time and that's the value, right? Let me stop that. So the logic goes something like this. Let me go to the templates. The code is there on my GitHub account, so make sure to check that out. I want to thank a guy because basically I have taken his code and I was trying to play with it. So this is not my original code, right? I have tweaked or I have modified this a little bit, right? So these are the links that you need to add. That's a high chart link, right? And that's the, let me get rid of that one. That's an extra actually. So basically we have a dev tag and we have an ID called as data container. That's where my chart will go inside, right? So that's the idea. So let's see the code or the JavaScript code. So I have a function called as request data, which is doing basically an AJAX call. So $get, and this is the route, right? This gives a vector of data, right? So then I say request.done. Once the request is done, what I do is basically I say var series equals to chart.series 0. Then shift equals to series.data.length, where is greater than 20. So once the data point is more than 20, it will start shifting the, it will basically discard the older values, right? Then we have add a point. So basically this takes a vector, right? Vector of 2 points, right? So basically shift and we give an argument known as true. And we set out a timeout, basically call this function every 2 seconds. That's the jQuery code. We create a new object of high charts, right? Then we say chart and we give it an render to. Where do you want to render to? Data container. Remember the data container is the dev tag that we just defined above. Data container. So where am I? Yeah, that's the one. So that's the data container. We have simple known as title, so live random data. We have x-axis basically representing date time, so the type is date time. Tick pixel is 150, zoom is 20 into 1000. Similarly the y-axis, some padding and nice title that I wanted to give. And of course it's a series data set, so series equal to name equals to random data, and data is blank because it's gonna be generating data dynamically, right? So that's the idea. So that's all the code is. It's pretty simple. I would be adding this code on my GitHub account, so if you have any more questions you can tweak this. But please, guys, if you know how can I add one more chart just below this, please do help me. I tried it basically. I just tried to copy paste the code and, you know, like tweak it a little bit, like create a new object and a new div tag with a different name. But it did not work. If you are able to make it work, I would be very happy. Please do share the code. We all are learning some always. So if you are good with this, please share your code or ideas so I can learn also, right? So I would conclude my video right here, and I hope you have enjoyed this. And this is the end of the charts with the Flask tutorial series. With that being said, all the codes and everything is there on my GitHub. So make sure to go on the GitHub and check it out. If you have any more questions, please list them in the comment section. Would be very happy to assist you. As usual, thank you very much for your love and support. I would see you guys in the next video. All right. Goodbye. Keep smiling. Keep coding. See you guys in the next video.